From the shotgun, Joe Burrow. And the Raiders have got him. Max Crosby picks up his second sack of the afternoon.
He's known for his legs and his fancy footwork, but he's not getting much of a chance to use it here. The defense continued to hold the upper hand by bringing him down on that play.
The Bengals bring out their punter now, as he'll come on to kick this one away. This is taken around the 12 and out of bounds across the 15-yard line. The Raider offense set to get this drive started. They'll begin on the ground with Jacobs. And he roams across the 20 to the 24-yard line. And as they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. Second down and 3. Garoppolo looks to throw. The open man here, Renfro. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. Running straight ahead is Jacobs, and he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up. Looking to throw, Garoppolo. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Adams. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. Jacobs going to try the middle. And across midfield he goes and into Bengal territory. From the 48-yard line, here's 2nd and 5. They'll stay on the ground with Jacobs. Despite the strong run, he'll be hit and dropped shy of the 45. 7th play of the drive now as they come up on a 3rd and 3. To throw, it's Garoppolo. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. His 32-yard line. 14 yards is the pickup there at a Raider first. And we are keeping a close eye on his catches, a really close eye now, because that's number 899 in his career. The next one will give him 900. From the 32 now, here's 1st and 10. Working from the gun, Garoppolo.
A short throw, and that's hauled in by Mayer.
Now this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on 1st down. White running to the left. A gain of 5, good enough for the 1st down. How about this offensive line? They're really starting to establish themselves, take over this game.
And before the series began, I know exactly what we said in the defensive huddle. Guys, we got to get no less than a 3 and out. Let's get off the field. Instead, they can't find any traction towards doing that. Right now, they're just getting muscled all over the field and getting pushed down it.
It'll be a gain of 5, and it's 2nd down.
How about the timing on that one? Boy, they were in sync, weren't they? 3-step drop, balls out of his hands, right to the tight end. Nice completion, just like they do it in practice.
Here's a 2nd and 5. Back to throw here. The pass taken in by Mayer. Only able to gain a couple there. And this will wind up being a 3rd and 3.
Oh, it's time to give a little credit there to the defense. They played that very well because it was a drag route, and he ran a little shallower than normal as he worked straight across the field. He was hoping he'd get lost behind the defensive line, but once he made the catch, nowhere to turn upfield and gain any yardage.
Meanwhile, on 3rd down, they take a shot at the end zone, but it's incomplete. The kick by Carlson is good. And high fives for that one as that drive ends in three. From a defensive perspective, though, I think maybe they're saying, hey, we did what we needed to do, kept this a one-score game.
Yeah, without a doubt, because they were able to bleed some time off the clock, right? Put themselves in a good position, but it's not out of reach yet, okay? Being able to hold them to a field goal means that they do have a chance to come back and win this game.
The Bengals set to take over. Burrow going to lead up the Bengals here, first and 10 at their 25-yard line. They'll begin on the ground here with Evans. And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe three.
Here we go.
From the 29, here's a second and 7. Here's Burrow. And he rifles one incomplete. Bengals on third down. They're hitting at 60%, 6 out of 10 thus far. This is third and 7. The pass to Boyd, and he brings it in on the crossing route. And he is going to have a Bengals first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
I like the design that we're seeing right there. This is what they need. Down by a touchdown here in the fourth. They just need to keep working their way downfield. And when they see openings, take their shots.
So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. Now back to throw. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and 2.
Well, that's always a good place to throw it just because he's one of the biggest targets not only on this team but in the National Football League.
And you and I both know the quarterbacks love these large body tight ends, and why not? Nowadays, they're really wide receivers who are just taller and have a little bit more weight. These guys catch the football, make big plays downfield. In the old days, we wanted them to block. Now coaches want them to catch the football first.
Here we go. Now after the false start, here's second and 7.
Here we go.
And Burrow going to throw again. And this is incomplete. They head to the line facing a third and 7 following the incompletion on second down. Now it's Burrow. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And he is going to have a Bengals first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
The drive continues as they search for a tying touchdown. Here's first and 10. Here's a handoff to Evans out of the gun. And he'll get this down only to about the 46. Now Burrow to throw on second down. Throwing middle, and it's complete. A gain of 8 there on the 8th play of the drive. To make it 3 for 3 on third down conversions. They need a yard here. He'll look to throw, and that is incomplete. One score down. Here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down.
They'll try and throw forward with Burrow. Pass to the sideline and pulled in. And he's going to be out of bounds down around the 35-yard line. A new lease on life after the fourth down conversion. Here's first and 10. They'll look to throw again. Over the middle, that's caught by Chase. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. Well, certainly those are the types of mistakes they're trying to avoid as they attempt to protect this lead late in the game.
And let's face it, they're hoping that this one doesn't cost them in a significant way. Yeah, one guy committed a penalty, but now the entire defense has to pay the price and try and rise up and overcome it.
Second and 9. Back to the ground. Oh, no, he lost the football. And the Raiders pick it up. And he's into the clear. And he's into the end zone. It's a fumble return for 6 and a Raider touchdown. This was a close game. They needed a little breathing room. Boy, they got it right there on that return for a touchdown.
Yeah, we would say that this could be huge. Forget it. It was huge. Gave them a comfortable lead.
Carlson on for the PAT. Is up to 14. The scoop and score, always an exciting play in football, and we witnessed it there, grabbing it off the ground and then rumbling it into the end zone for 6. And you can bet they're preaching two hands on the ball here as the kick's away following that fumble return. This taken in right around the goal line. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28. Cincinnati set to take over once again. And that last possession, really a gut punch. You seemingly had it working. You were in the midst of a very strong drive, then suddenly the fumble, and you're watching the back of a defender's jersey as he brings it all the way in the other direction.
There's not much more I can add to that. I thought you summarized it perfectly, partner. You've just got to regroup and start putting another drive together. That's all you can do.
And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down. They'll come up second and 7. They're going to look to throw. And a quick throw here, that's complete. That one, a first down pickup of 8. But correct me if I'm wrong, yeah, you're down 2 scores. I don't think you need to rush just yet, but you can't take your time either.
Yeah, even if you don't want to commit to full 2-minute offense, you have to up the tempo, up the urgency. Maybe you're starting to call 2 plays in a huddle each time you snap the ball.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a 1st and 10. They'll look to throw. Over the middle, he finds Higgins. And he's going to be taken down. Plus, there's a penalty flag in the backfield. They may get 15 more on top of this. The Charles, they're trying to protect this lead late. Those are the types of mistakes they can afford to go without.
About the last thing you want to give them is help in completing a comeback, which is exactly what that penalty does.
Divine Diablo there to make the stop. From the 31, here's a 2nd and 8. Out of the gun, it's Burrow. This pass complete to Higgins. And he's going to have another 1st down as the tackle comes at the Raiders 19. From the gun, it's a run by Evans. This will be a 5-yard pickup as they move it from the 20 to the 15. Now Burrow. And that'll be incomplete. Well, the black hole and everyone in Vegas. Davis on their feet. Here's third down now. They're passing here. Joe Burrow. He's got Higgins over the middle. And he's brought down short by a yard. It's a third down gain of four. Two minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So the Bengals in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They come up on a fourth down situation with things not looking particularly rosy. And he's got the first down as he gets it to the eight. Now first and goal. Burrow. They're unable to connect, but a late flag comes in. And the contact may have come too early. And since the penalty occurred in the end zone, move the ball to the 1 yard line.
First and goal from the 1 yard line. Costly penalty.
So the ball's moved to about the one after the penalty. First and goal. Here's Burrow. And this is caught now for a late touchdown. So hold everything here. This one's not over yet. Okay, game on. Don't go anywhere yet. You got a one-score game now. Probably going to rely on the onside kick coming up.
Yeah, they have to. It's not a high percentage play, but it's better than not having a chance at all. And that's when you put your leapers and your flyers on one side, get that high hop, and hope that one of the guys can come up with it.
And on the other side, get that hands team ready.
No doubt about it.
Still an important piece of business to take care of, the extra point. And that'll cut the lead down now to a touchdown.
The kick is good. Let's do this.
So that drive consumes nine plays all told.
And it was T. Higgins who capped the drive with the touchdown reception. After the touchdown, McPherson on to kick this one away. And able to get this across the 20, but not much further as he's dropped at the 23-yard line. The Vegas offense ready for their next possession. Well, they can smell victory, partner. They can see it on the horizon, but certainly we're not done yet here. Defense still has three timeouts, and obviously this is a very slim lead they're holding on to.
And let's face it, the easiest way to get this done, challenge your ground game, challenge your offensive line, your tight ends, your receivers, anyone who's going to lay down a block. Don't let there be penetration because they're going to stack the line of scrimmage and maybe bring extra people to the ball. If you can do that, make them burn their timeouts, run out the clock, life will be good. But if you really want to gamble a little bit, a quick play action, quick throw, might be able to get it done. Just make sure it's not incomplete and stop the clock.
The Bengals going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll get it with just under 90 seconds remaining. They're not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. Five points of contact necessary at this stage as they'll run on first down. Now the Bengals going to signal for their third and final timeout. As they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Opting to run again here with White. And he's going to have a Raider first down. And that should be the one that finishes the script here. Clock counting down toward 40 seconds as they take the knee. And that kneel down a little extra sweet. You get the win, and you knock out somebody's perfect season.
Yeah, you're exactly right, because it's not a championship game yet, But the team that's undefeated feels like a champion. So you want a little bit extra in this one. Yeah, they've got to feel great about taking a knee here.
So this one, a victory for the Las Vegas Raiders.
And we talk so much about the turnover battle, determining who wins, who loses. This game, no exception. Air-free football, no turnovers at all, and they win it.
So this is one you don't have to convince your team that what you're saying is accurate. And you know what I'm talking about. Head coach always stands up in front of the team and says, guys, if we do this, this, and this, we'll win. And usually they say, if we win the turnover battle, we'll win. Well, here's the proof right there. Win the turnover battle, go on to victory. Now the guys believe. You move on to the next lesson where you have to convince them. This one is now planted.
So for Las Vegas, their good start continues as they get their record up to 4-2. And they'll get to stay home again next week. Meanwhile, for Cincinnati, they taste defeat for the first time this season as they drop to 5-1. And they'll get a chance to redeem themselves at home next week. So for Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. Next game, guess what? Charles and I will be here again. It's the NFL on EA Sports.